Hi friends, welcome to my videos. So today in this video I'm going to show you how to step by step online apply for a visitor visa to Canada. Before I proceed further, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe because I regularly upload videos, and if you have any concern, any question, anything that comes in your mind, feel absolutely free to ask. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So guys, because we are going to use MyCIC account, that's why you need to first have your MyCIC account where you can file your online application. So I have already published a video about how to create one. If you don't know, then the link is in the description. Go ahead and create one MyCIC account for yourself. Alright guys, so for this sample video, what we are going to consider there is a citizen of India. His name is John Smith and he has a brother. His name is, let's say, Victor Smith. So Victor Smith is in Canada. He is a permanent resident here. So Victor Smith is gonna be married to Stella Smith, and he has invited his brother John Smith to attend his wedding. So this is just a sample case. Like, there could be many cases. Sometimes you don't even need an invitation when you are just going for tourism to do sightseeing and all. But for this sample video, I have considered this, that Victor Smith has invited John Smith to attend Victor's marriage with Stella Smith. Alright, so the very first thing is to click here, apply to come to Canada. We don't have personal reference code, so click here, visitor visa study or visit permit. What would you like to do, Canada? You want to visit? How long you are planning to stay in Canada? Less than 6 months. So let's say he wants to come here for 2 weeks. Okay, that makes sense. When you want to attend a wedding, he will come a few days in advance, and then in order to attend some pre-wedding functions, and then after wedding a few days staying together, he would go back. This is what the plan is. Select the code that matches one of you on your passport. So let's say India. What is your current country or territory? He is in India. He is an Indian citizen. John Smith. Do you have a family member who is a Canadian citizen, permanent resident, and 18 years older? Yes, he has. What is his date of birth? So let's say John was born in 1995. Okay. 1995. Here you go. August 1st. Just a sample date of birth. Have you lived in Canada as a permanent resident and landing permit? Let's say no. Next. Is he a green card holder? No. How are you related to your family member? Brother, sister, aunt, uncle, whatever is applicable. And this is applicable in this case. What is your marital status? Let's say John is unmarried. Never married, single. If married, then you gotta select married, and then accordingly you need to take up the further questionnaire. What is your province of destination? Let's say his brother Peter Smith, Victor Smith lives in Ontario. So after this questionnaire, he can come on this visitor visa under 6 months. So click on continue. Continue. Few more questions. What is the main purpose of your visit? So to visit family and or friends. Do you have proof of relationship with the person who is inviting you to Canada? Let's say yes. Now some other questions. Do you have a job in the country where you currently live? Yes. Do you own a business in the country where you currently live? Let's say no, because he works. For example, like, he works at a company. Do you depend on someone for financial support? No. Have you traveled to other countries in the previous 10 years? Let's say he has traveled. Countries like Nepal, Thailand. Something, we'll see what they ask in the questionnaire. Are you accompanying a family member that has a status in Canada or has recently been approved to come to Canada? So if you see the explanation, this means you will be staying with a family member who is already in Canada or has applied to come to Canada or has been accepted as a visitor, worker or student. So yes, he will be staying with his brother. Have you ever committed, let's say he has a clean criminal history, absolutely clean? Have you had a medical exam? No. Do you want to submit an application for family member? No. So this basically is required, like suppose you are married and you have a wife, then in that case you select yes, and if you have a kid, then again this becomes yes. So in that case you need to fill IMM 5713 form, where you get their consent to apply their application using your MyCIC account. Are you giving access to someone? No. I mean, he doesn't want to appoint any representative. In the past 10 years, have you given fingerprint photo? Let's say no. Let's say he has visited other countries, but he never had to go through biometrics or anything. There are fees associated with this application. Yes, he'll be paying the application fee because he's an Indian passport holder. Are you able to make a digital copy? Yes, because he's going to apply online. Will you be paying fees online? Yes. Here you can review all the answers that have been put in. If you're okay, click on continue. Now click on continue. And here you see the checklist. So they ask you to pay 185. 100 is for visa fee and 85 is the biometric fee. Because you selected, you have not gone through. Alright, so we'll go through this one by one. Okay, so we'll come to this section later. First, let's start with this. Okay, so this form is open. Application for a visitor visa, temporary resident visa. So you see a unique client identifier. So this could be an 8-digit number or a 10-digit number, where IRCC uniquely identifies a client. So if you have ever applied to IRCC before, you can see this UCI mentioned in any communication that you have received. But if this is your first application, then you can just leave it blank. This is not mandatory. So I assume John has never applied before, so leave it. I want service in English. Visa requested. Visitor visa, yes. Full name as per the passport. So his name is Smith John. Have you used any other name? No. Whatever is applicable in your case. He is male, 1995. 0801, place of birth, New Delhi, country, India, citizenship, India, current country, he is living in India, so India, whatever is applicable in your case, status, he is a citizen. Okay. During the past 5 years, have you lived in any country or territory other than your country of citizenship or your current country or territory of residence for more than 6 months? No. Whatever is applicable in your case. Same as country or territory of residence, country or territory where applying, yes, he is applying from India. Your current marital status, he has never married. Single. Have you previously married and then become single? No, he was never married, so no. Language. Let's say he's from India, so his mother tongue is Hindi. Are you able to communicate in English or French? Let's say English. Okay, have you taken any exam? No. Passports. His Indian passport, so let's say L. Country, let's say India. Issue date, let's say this was issued in 2015. I can pick the date here also. Then let's say 2015, July 1st it was issued. And it is valid till 2025, June 30. Okay. These two, because you already selected India, so next two questions about Taiwanese and Israeli passport, not required. Go to the next. Do you have a nationality document? So if you select no, this is going to be disabled. You select yes, it's these two are important, and issue date and expiry date not there. Now every country does have some nationality documents. For example, if you are in India, you have Aadhaar card, PAN card. So when I filed the very first application for me, I mean, this question is asked in many IRCC forms. So I put PAN card number. So if you want, you can put if you have Aadhaar number, whatever you have. I'm just trying to create a sample number. Issue date, if you have like on PAN card, you don't have issue date or expiry date, so you can leave it blank. If it is available on your Aadhaar card, just put that. But be accurate here also, because they may ask you this at a later stage. You never know. Are you a green card holder? Let's say no. Okay, next is current mailing address. Let's say apartment 1, street 1, New Delhi Street, city town, New Delhi, country India, postal code. I don't know any Delhi postal code, but I created one. District Delhi. Residential address same as mailing address? Yes. Telephone number other, definitely he's not in Canada. So let's say he has a cellular phone. 919999. Okay. He has one official phone also, business phone. 918888. He doesn't have a fax number, so leave it. Email address. Details of visit to Canada. So we have selected family visit. Yeah. How long you are planning to stay? So let's say, as I said, 2 weeks. So let's say he is going in October 31st and he'll be returning in November 16. Just 2 weeks, at two weekends I have covered. Funds available for his stay. So let's say he has around 15,000 Canadian dollars. Name and address or relationship, any personal, you will. So let's say, as I said, Victor Smith. Brother or sibling, whatever you want to write. Address in Canada, let's say 1 Toronto Street, Toronto, Ontario, this is not even an existing postal code, so don't use it. Education, have you had any post-secondary education including, let's say, yes. So he was born in 1995, so let's say from 2013 to 17, he has studied, so 2013, let's say 06 to 2017, 06 field of study, let's say Bachelor's of Technology in IT, schools, let's say New Delhi College, New Delhi School, whatever sample it is, city town, New Delhi, country India. Okay, employment. Employed past 10 years, including if you have held any government position such as civil servant, member, hospital. Do not leave gaps. If retired, not working or studying, please indicate. If you are retired, please provide 10 years before. So here, past 10 years. So let's say, okay, so this is current one, so we can put the same, his current employment. Let's say he was graduated in 6, so 2017-7 he started working, IT analyst, company New Delhi Softwares. sorry. So 10 years, so I mean to, from 2000 up to 2009 we need to provide the information. City, town, New Delhi, country, India. Okay. You can say before that, studying bachelor's of IT. Okay, bachelor's of engineering in IT. Whatever you wrote above. From so we have this date here, let's say it's match 2013-06-2017-06 New Delhi, India. Okay, now we need to cover from okay so 2009 they have asked for last 10 years so 09 to 2013-05 studying in school. You can say, oh here I missed New Delhi softwares, I apologize. Company, employer, let's say, oh no, New Delhi school, he was studying here. Here let's say public school Delhi. And this is just a sample, whatever dates, whatever applicable in your case, just don't go after it. Country or territory, India. In the past 2 years, have you or your family member had tuberculosis? Let's say no. Whatever is applicable in your case. Do you have any physical or mental disorder that would require social or health service other than, let's say no. Have you ever remained beyond the validity of your state attended school? Let's say no. Have you ever been refused visa? Let's say no. Have you previously applied to inter remain gunner? Let's say no. Have you ever been committed charged? No. Have you served military? No. Have you ever administered with any political party? No. A witness participated in the ill treatment of prisoners, civil, let's say no. Signature. Do you consent to be contacted in future? Yes. Date. Okay, when you sign electronically, you don't need to do anything. Because you can leave here, you can even type your name because you need to save and upload, and when you submit the application at that time you sign it electronically. So for now I'm just going to save it. Okay, now I'm going to go back to my session to see if my session is still. Yeah. So here click on upload file. Okay guys, now I understood what was going wrong. Like after I finished this form, before I save, I had to click on validate. That's very important. Because if I have done any mistake, it points it out over there. So if the validation message is successful, that doesn't mean that still I have submitted the form. I mean, I have entered the form correctly. There could be errors also. But yes, it's a good opportunity. After doing this, verify everything once more before you finally submit. So I'm going to save it and I'll try to upload. Okay, I'm going to try to upload again. Okay, so as I said, this is uploaded. Next, travel history. Let's see what they say. You must provide information on your valid visa from the United States as well as previous travel history. This can include copies of your previous visa used last in your country, entry or exit stamp, study work permit, indicated duration outside your country, expired or valid visa. If you hold a valid visa from another, provide a clear scanned copy of your visa, whatever. So this is about your travel history, and this depends on whatever you selected in the questionnaire. So you need to provide, as they have provided the information here. I'm just going to upload a sample document here. Passport. So for passport, they have shown legible copy. It showed. It must show your date of birth, country of origin, and any page of stamp, visa, and marking. So again, I'm going to upload a sample document here. Next, invitation letter. So he has been invited by his brother. So it should cover all such pieces of information. I'm sorry, I just clicked on the link. So in this case it will be applicable up to here because he is not being invited to any business. So click on upload file. Okay, this is done. Proof of means of financial support. You can see what they are asking. Temporary residence. So he is a temporary resident. If you are going to visit, you can provide support yourself and the family members will bring. Bank statement, bank draft, pay stubs, employment letter, proof of asset business. A letter from person institution providing you with money. Proof of funding made from within Canada if you have a scholarship or in Canadian foundation or Canadian bank account in your name if money has been transferred to Canada. So yeah, you can see that what are the documents are required, and you have already entered the amount of funds available. And the invitation that you get from your relative, they can also write in the letter that they will be providing you with accommodation, food and other things that are required. So that always adds value to your application. Next, digital photo. So standards are given here, temporary resident. So just follow it up and get it done from a good photographer. Purpose of travel, other required. You must submit proof that you are coming to Canada for a temporary. Example, you can provide proof, your flight tickets departing Canada, your travel itinerary, proof of medical appointment. Yeah. So, I mean, this is about your temporary stay. So here, definitely attach your returning ticket. And also whatever you have in your country, like dependencies, like if you have been granted leave from the employer, include that letter. If your property is in your name, include that piece of information. Anything that you want to submit that you are coming to Canada on a temporary visit and you will leave Canada on time. So that you need to upload over here. This again is going to be applicable as per your case. Next is family information form. So I've already uploaded a video about how to fill this form. I'm not going to walk you through again with this, but the link is available in the description. Go ahead and watch if about how to fill this up. Okay. Next is proof of relation. So here you see this generic test. Of course, this is not applicable because you are not married to your brother. So, and you cannot be a parent also. But any document that indicates, any official document, so whatever evidence you have, you can provide that. I mean, it could be property documents, affidavit, anything. Like, it depends even upon countries. In some countries, maybe in birth certificates, they include, I don't know, but whatever that is required to prove the relationship. Or another thing you can do is like get the passport copy of your brother and include yours. So there you can see, you can show the same parents and anything that proves your relationship. Okay, now these two are optional documents, but I strongly recommend to fill this. I am not going to walk you through 5 to 5-7 because I've already uploaded a video. You can go ahead and watch that. Client information is also not mandatory, but I strongly recommend. So in client information, what you write, like you address it to the case officer and you write that this is what you are, this is what you are planning to do, these are the documents that you have. and this is what they prove. So it should make sense, like for a third person who is completely unaware of your case, your circumstances, your situation, he or she should read this and should clearly get a positive impression and all the possible details about your application. And based on the type of application, like in this case, this is a temporary application, it should make sense that yes, you will leave Canada at the end of your visa duration or as per the application that you have made. So you need to even also include information like yes, I have shown dependency to my country that compel me to return, like my property, my job, my parents, my commitments, all such things. And it should make sense, and along with documentation. Alright, so once you are through all that, I have not uploaded sample documents here, but yes, I strongly suggest you do. Then click next. Here you are going to do electronic signature. You select I agree, you put the information and the security question and you sign. So I'm not going to go through here because I don't want to put an application in their system for no reason, because this is just a sample, and in the next screen they will ask me to pay $185 that I don't want to pay now. So this is how it works, and this is going to vary in every case based on the questionnaire that you answer and your circumstances. So this is just a sample case to walk you through the process, because the main process remains the same. So I hope you like this video. Make sure to give it a like and comment, and if you have any concern, any question, anything that comes in mind, feel absolutely free to